दिस इज़ राकेश कुमार फ्रॉम चंडीगढ़ पॉलीटेक्निक कॉलेज ई सी डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अवर ई आई एम चैप्टर नंबर सेकेंड, दैट इज़ द ट्रांसड्यूसर्स। बेसिकली अ ट्रांसड्यूसर इज़ अ डिवाइस दैट कन्वर्ट्स वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी इन टू अनदर फॉर्म। इफ़ यू टॉक अबाउट ऑफ एन एनर्जी से लाइक साउंड एनर्जी हैज़ बीन कन्वर्टेड इन टू electrical energy, that is the function of transistor, which it converts the sound energy into electrical energy. First of all, we are going to discuss about the difference between active and passive transducer. Actually, there are two types of transducer available in the market, that are the active and passive transducer. As the name itself indicates, the active transducers converts the one form of energy into another form without using an external source. As the first point mentioned here tells about its function, that is the major difference between active and passive transducer is that an active transducer has the ability to convert one form of energy into another form of energy, say electrical, but without using an external source of power. It can convert the form of energy into another form without using an external power source that is not required in active transducers. But on the other hand, if we talk about the other type of transducer, that is the passive transducer, it converts a form of energy into another form by making a use of an external power source. That is the compulsory requirement of passive transducer, that it needs an external power source for the conversion of energy from one form to another form. Active transducers are also known as self-generating transducers, while passive transducers are also known as externally energized transducers, because passive transducers needs external power source for its function. Second point tells us the examples of active and passive transducers. Piezoelectric crystal and thermocouple are the examples of active transducers, while potentiometer and thermistors are the examples of passive transducers. Next slide shows the basic requirement that are essential for transducers. First one is the linearity. As its name indicates, the linearity shows the characteristics between its input and output. For every increase or change in input, there must be a change in output. That is the linearity property of a transducer. Second one is the ruggedness. It tells about the ability of the transducer to withstand over load and protection measures. Third one is the repeatability. That is the ability to produce same output for same input at different times and environment. This is the repeatability of the transducer that can produce the same output for the same input. Next is the high stability and reliability of the transducer. This parameter shows how much our transducer is stable and reliable. That is, the output should not be affected by temperature, vibration, other environmental condition with minimum error. That is, the high stability and reliability tells all about the transducer basic requirements. Next is the good dynamic response, that tells about the ability to change output quickly for dynamic variation in input with respect to the time. Last one is the good mechanical characteristics. It is the ability to withstand deformation and deterioration in performance caused by various mechanical strains. All these are the basic requirements of a transducer that we must aware about the transducer before we will study any type of transistor, all these requirements, basic requirements about the transistor, we all must know. First, here comes the strain gauge, that is the resistive type of transducer. The strain gauge, as its name indicates, it is a resistor that is used to measure the strain on an object. When an external force is applied on an object, due to which there is deformation occurs in the shape of the object, the strain that occurs on the object can change the shape of the object. This deformation in the shape is called the strain, and it is measured by the strain gauge. By measuring the change in resistance of an object, actually when we apply an external force on any object, the shape of object will change, and according to that, the resistance of object will also change, and the amount of induced stress can be calculated by using the strain gauge. Actually, the strain gauge has a long, thin metallic strip arranged in a zigzag pattern on a non-conducting material. The slide on the right side shows the zigzag pattern of the strain gauge, and this is the quarter bridge strain gauge circuit through which we can measure the strain that is applied on the object. By using this Wheatstone bridge, we can measure it easily. Strain gauge bridge circuit, as shown in previous slide, shows the measured stress and uses a voltmeter, as you can see here, and between the resistance R1 and R2, we have used here a voltmeter in the center of the bridge to provide an accurate measurement of that imbalance that occurs when external force is applied on the object. In the circuit R1 and R3, you can see here in this previous slide, R1 and R3 are the ratio arms equal to each other. Both R1 and R3 have the same values in this bridge circuit, and R2 is the rheostat arm, has a value equal to the strain gauge resistance. On the right hand side, that where we have used R1 and R3, both of these resistors have the same value, and R2 and strain gauge on the left hand side have the same resistance value. When the gauge is unstrained, means that we have not applied any type of external force to the object, the bridge is in its balanced condition and voltmeter will show a zero value. As there is a change in resistance of strain gauge, the bridge gets unbalanced and produced an indication at the voltmeter. As you can see, a voltmeter has been attached in the center of the bridge. For any change in resistance of the strain gauge, voltmeter will show a reading according to the change in its resistance. This image shows the actual strain gauge that we use practically. This slide shows the application of strain gauge, where we can use strain gauge. The strain gauges are extensively used in the field of geotechnical monitoring to keep a constant check on structures, dams, tunnels, and buildings so that the mishaps can be avoided well on time. All this is about the basics of the transducers, the active transducer and the passive transducers. And also we have studied the basic requirements that are required for a transducer. And the strain gauge that comes under the category of resistive transducer, we have studied here. A strain gauge, as you can see in the diagram, is available in a zigzag pattern that has a long thin metallic strip arrangement. It actually measures the strain when an external force is applied on the object. Accordingly, the strain gauge changes its resistance, and that resistance change can be measured with the help of voltmeter attached in the center of the bridge circuit, as you can see in the slide here. And this strain gauge can be used in the structure dam tunnels and buildings so that minor to minor cracks can be detected in that structures, in that geotechnical monitoring arrangement, that mishaps can be avoided well on time. Thank you.